Asthma, the disease of respiratory system. First, the role of respiratory system is exchange of gases through inhalation and exhalation by means of a simple tube like argon, nothing but our airway. So then coming to our topic, asthma, it is a chronic disorder which is supposed to narrow the airway by means of inflammation or any of the bronchospasm. Basically, it is majorly found in case of children. So we might not know the basic reasons for asthma, but we have some triggers for asthma. Like in case of emotional stress or physical activities or exercises, even some like diseases or infections, what it happens is some bronchospasm is there. So because of the bronchospasm, so the narrowing of airway is happening, which does not allow the airway to take the lots of air inside the respiratory system. And then even in the time of drug additives, allergens, pollens, in that case, because of the a foreign material comes into our body refuses to enter the foreign material into our body, that causes inflammatory sensation, which causes the release of mucus, that also might be a trigger for asthma. Then what is the cause for asthma? Basically we don't know what is the exact cause of asthma, even though we may expect some causes for asthma. What are they? If the parents are already having the asthma, then because of that reason, their children may get a chance to get asthma, or otherwise wasting, atopy, nothing but death of the cells. Some wasting leads to decreases the cell number in the airway, which leads to asthmatic conditions, or otherwise childhood respiratory infections, which is may causes a damage of alpha antitrypsin, that also leads to asthmatic condition. And the other reason is allergens, pollens, or any infections which trigger out our immune systems, like which causes the release of mucus in respiratory tract or airway, that leads to asthmatic condition. Then what is the pathogenesis? As we discussed earlier, so one is bronchospasm, so narrowing of airway, like by constructing the airway section. Whenever alpha antitrypsin is that element which causes, which may responsible for elasticness of the airway. If in case any of the emotional stress or conditions of fight or flight mode, we have a release of noradrenaline in our body, which causes the constriction of all the, whatever we can say, conditions that leads to bronchospasm, or otherwise any of the airway inflammation. So that two things leads to reduction of airway diameter, and which causes. So in case of bronchospasm, we have a condition of reduction of airway diameter. In case of airway inflammation, we have a condition of excessive release of mucus or constriction of smooth muscles, which may lead to narrowing of airway. And then while you are observing this picture, this is the normal airway we have, in which we have a space for air. And then when we have a, during the asthmatic conditions, we have a vasoconstriction, whatever bronchoconstriction is there, and along with the mucus secretions, enlargement of this muscle is there, along with the mucus secretion is there, which will blocks the air entry into the respiratory system. And then how does it happen? Simply look after this. Whenever any of the allergen is entered into our body, that leads to initiate the inflammatory response. Inflammatory response is nothing but the vascular changes that happens in our body. So due to a opposition happens by our body, the mucus gets released into the body, and that causes asthmatic condition in our body. Like the factors causing, while any of the entry of the like pollens or any of the dust particles, that causes the mucus secretion in our body. If any of the noradrenaline release or affecting of alpha antitrypsin in our body leads to constriction of bronchial muscle, that factors leads to asthmatic conditions. Then what is the symptom? Well, if a person get asthma, what they are supposed to expose? So one is coughing, wheezing, tightness of chest. So if the airway is not allowing us to take the breath, then there is no oxygen is there in our respiratory system, which leads to activation of anaerobic pathway. Because of that reason, we get irritation, like shortness of breath or any of the tightness of chest because of the anaerobic pathway activation. Along with that, coughing and sneezing is also there. So how may we diagnose the patient having asthma or not? So we have so many diagnostic studies is there. First of all, the historical or physical examination of the patient, how he is exposing and whether his parents or he is having any inflammations or infections prior, respiratory infections prior in their life, or after your blood gases level, like oxygen level in the body, or spirometers. You can see the spirometer here, which can assess the inhaled and exhaled gases in the body. And then we can even having the peak motors here, that is also using the same manner like a spirometer. And then chest x-rays, if any of the inflammations or infections inside the chest or any of the damage or blasting of the cells in the bronchioles can be assessed by the x-rays. And other diagnostic studies is methacholine challenge. It is a diagnosis tool which can be analyzed, which can be used to analyze the various conditions of asthma, and also allergy test. And nitric oxide is nothing but the spasmic creating element in our body. Basically, it is helpful in the case of constriction, like increasing of blood pressure and all. So decreasing the blood pressure and all. And then any of the allergen conditions, culture test is used to assess the asthmatic condition in our body. And then these are the drugs like bronchodilators, which can support to enlarge our bronchioles and can decrease shortly release from the bronchial constrictions. And then anti-inflammatory, if that asthmatic condition is happened because of any inflammatory vascular changes, vascular response, then it's supposed to suppress the inflammatory response, and by means of that it can treat the person in a better manner. Or even the mast cell stabilizers. Mast cells are also like inhibition of release of histamines, which leads to decreases the inflammatory response. Corticosteroids and mast cell stabilizers are the best examples for anti-inflammatory drugs. And in case of corticosteroids, it suppresses the inflammatory response. And in case of mast cells, it inhibits the release of histamines, which is the best leading element in the inflammatory response. And the last in but not the least, leukotriene modifiers, which will potently bronchoconstrict, opposite to the edema conditions or inflammation in the body.